and environmental problems, reasons, consequences and remedies. Ladies and gentlemen, this topic is of great relevance in the present time because there is a strong need of good environment. Not merely a good environment, but an anxiety to preserve and protect our planet. In the present scenario, it is highly required that we must always be ready to debate and issue to timely introspection. And this platform of conference is therefore a welcome step facilitating thinkers from diverse backgrounds to assemble and put their hands together on these concerns from the perspective of human life, because debates have the potential not only identify the causes and effects, but also throw up for consideration the corrective measures. Friends, going with the agenda of this conference, I'm sure that scope for environmental changes and its overall impact on the humanity in various aspects of human activities would have already been debated and discussed at length by ways of existing solution to prevent irreversible damages to our planet. Many factors are contributing to climate change, from fossil fuel used to the burning and clearing of tropical forest. So we need a comprehensive approach to reduce the impact of climate changes and an approach that decreases emission across all sectors and enhances the adaptive capacity of all the society. Since I am associated with Legal Aid Movement, so it is my duty to tell you that in our constitution, it is clearly stated that it is duty of the state to protect and improve the environment and to safeguard the forest and wildlife of our country, because it imposes a duty on every citizen to protect and improve the natural environment, including forest, lakes, rivers, and wildlife. And references to the environment has already been discussed, mentioned in directive principle of state, as well as fundamental rights. The constitutional provisions are backed by a number of laws, acts, rules, and notifications, which are to be executed at all level. The Environment Protection Act 1986 came into force soon after Bhopal gas tragedy, and it is considered as umbrella legislation. Friends, as I am not a good listener, nor I am a good speaker, so in the middle of this my speech, I would like to conclude my speech by requesting all of you, please come forward again and again for betterment of our environment in future also, because more efforts are to be done for implementation of law and enforcement of environmental law. So in the last but not the least, I am very much thankful to Mrs. Mim Sharma, Managing Director, and Shri Gurcharan Das, Principal, for giving me an opportunity to interact with all of you. I congratulate all the participants, winners of different activities. God bless you. Thank you.
Thanks, Shri.
And sharing with us their findings and opinions. I am extremely thankful to Shri Harish Gupta Ji, for the chief guest of today's function, for sparing his valuable time to grace today's occasion. I express my heartiest gratitude to our respected Dr. Ajay Singh Ji Chautala and respected Vice Chairman Shri Mahinda Pal Singh Ji Barad for always being the source of inspiration and motivation. I would like to take this opportunity to express our hearty thanks to Dr. Shamim Sharma, Managing Director JCDB, for her continuous support and guidance that she has extended to all of us. Thank you, ma'am, for always being there. I also extend my thanks to convener of this conference and principal of JCDM College of Engineering, Dr. Gurcharan Das, for his huge support and guidance in the organization of this event.